Okay, so. Okay, so last week I shared this test with you. And it prompted the discussion about how you can have different function in your left hip versus your right hip. So you might be stronger in your adductors on one side or your glute medius on the other side. But this week we're talking about internal rotation versus external rotation of your hip. And the same sort of conversation applies. You can have one hip that likes to go one direction and one hip that likes to go the other direction. And so you address what you find. Like if you lack internal rotation on the left side, then you work on trying to get more motion and more strength going that direction. If you lack external rotation on the right side, then you work to try to get more strength and more motion going that direction. And so today's reel is trying to break that down for you a little bit to give you ideas of how you would address gaining motions or strength specifically to one side. So let me know what questions you have about this. All right, so I had two really great questions in my comments that I wanted to address in here because I feel like a lot of people probably feel this way. So one of them was, I am in an anterior pelvic tilt, so going forward, okay, this way, but I lack internal rotation. So that actually is not true, but there's a really good reason why you feel that way. Okay, so in order for me to internally rotate, it takes my pelvis and dumps it forward. As my hips go forward, as my hips rotate in, it dumps my pelvis forward. It sticks my bum out behind me. As my legs externally rotate, it relatively dumps my pelvis backwards, okay, going the other direction. So from the model, okay, so from the model, as you internally rotate your hips, your pelvis will spill forward. As you externally rotate your hips, your pelvis will tilt backwards. But a lot of people feel like even though they're rotated outwards, they're spilling forward because their hip is rotated outwards, but from higher up, they're arching their back in order to spill forward. So if you just look at the orientation of the pelvis to the ground, it looks like it is spilled forward. But if you look at what's going on in your hip, you're still holding tension in the back of your hip that has you externally rotated. So from that standpoint, you need more internal rotation to be able to change that position of your pelvis. But this is the sort of thing where it feels a lot like we're splitting hairs, and even people who spend their lives, even people who spend their lives describing whether or not a pelvis is anteriorly rotated or posteriorly rotated cannot always agree amongst themselves because there are so many factors to consider. Like, are we looking at the pelvis relative to the floor? Are we looking at the pelvis relative to the hips? So that's why I'm trying to offer you other ideas other than calling it an anterior pelvic tilt or a posterior pelvic tilt. But where are you holding tension? If you're holding tension in the back of your hip, you are not technically anteriorly rotated, at least by the way that my brain thinks of it. You could probably find a different definition that would say that you were. But if you want to go about changing that, the mechanics that you have to change is what is going on at the hip. And if you're holding tension that externally rotates your hip, we've got to let go of that by internally rotating. So whatever you call the pelvis position, you have to change the balance so that the hips can both internally and externally rotate. So if you're somebody who feels like you're holding tension in both the small of your back and the back of your hip, you are much likely to be standing with externally rotated hips and to be posteriorly tilting your pelvis, because the people who are internally rotated are holding tension up here and not down here. So when you're internally rotated, you're not holding tension in the back of your hip. You've created length in the back of your hip. So hopefully that makes it more clear and not more confusing. Please ask me if you still have questions about this one. And the second comment that I got that I felt like was really good was somebody asked me, so am I supposed to address the side that has pain? And my answer to that is always, do not chase pain. The pain is the effect. It isn't the cause. So you could have pain on one side that is being caused by the other side, or you could have pain on one side that is being caused by that side. So the solution in my mind is to work towards achieving more balance. And balance means like flexibility, but also strength. And it means from the front versus the back, but it also means from the left versus the right. And it also means from your ability to rotate one way and your ability to rotate the other way. We need balanced strength and balanced motion in all of those planes. And when you don't have it, then somebody ends up having to work harder than somebody else. And when you work towards creating balance, it will often result in changes in your pain because you're more evenly distributing the workload. And if it doesn't result in changes in your pain, then that's when we start to think that maybe your pain isn't mechanical and that there's some other source behind it. But usually when you even out the workload, that's when you see a change in pain. The pain is your body trying to communicate with you. It isn't the cause of what's wrong. So hopefully that clarifies that point.